Hey guys, Thackery here. We are going to discuss day number 9 rudiment, the Flam Drag. So this is the 9th rudiment of January. Congratulations for making it this far. The Flam Drag, coolest rudiment by far. Next to cheeses, of course, but very cool rudiment, a little bit difficult to play because it requires everything that you've learned before about your flam and your diddles. It requires you to be able to take all that information and do it all at the same time. So, cool rudiment, spend a lot of time practicing it right. So let's jump right into how to do that. First thing, first part of the name is the flam. Make sure your flams are solid. One thing that I see a lot of drummers do is they float their flams. They do this. Unless you're a Swiss drummer or you're playing for visual effect, you don't need to do that. Keep the lower stick down and let the higher stick do all of the action. First thing. Second rule, close your flam up. When you're playing flam drags flat, flam drags fast, say that 5 times, you're not going to have time to have your sticks doing anything other than what they have to do. You're not going to have time to be raising your grace note stick when you need to get that diddle in there. So first two rules, make sure your flam is closed and make sure you keep your flam technically accurate. Second rule, go back and review your diddles and make sure your diddles are solid. If you are still having trouble playing a roll at low volume, you might want to go back and review that, because playing diddles softly while playing them solid, I like to call playing through the head, that's a skill that you're going to have to master, because later when you're playing on a snare drum, it'll be much more audible when somebody is playing softly and their playing sounds very weak. So make sure that you're able to play diddles solidly yet down at tap level, because in a flam drag, the diddles are at tap height and your accent is at whatever height the dynamic range demands or indicates. So flam drag, again, flam followed by a drag, flam followed by a drag. Practice it starting with your dominant hand, which for me would be my right. And also practice it with your non-dominant hand, which would be my left. Okay, so that is rudiment number 9. Practice it with a check pattern. Everyone knows the flam accent. That'll also highlight if your flams are played properly, because you should hear 3 distinct notes instead of... Some people who haven't mastered the flam, moving on to the flam accent, they struggle because they can't close their flam up. So make sure your flam is closed on your flam accent check pattern. Okay? Then add the diddle in. So do it like a typical check pattern exercise grid. Slower.